Do you also think that creating web applications with Delphi can be a complex and time-consuming task? Well, for the front-end, the client application, we already went a long way with TMS WEB Core to give you RED, component-based, Object Pascal-based web application creation, reusing all the skills that you have for many years in creating VCL applications. For the server part, the part that deals with the communication between the client and your database on the server, this can be a quite steep learning curve where you need to take into account the security with authentication and authorization, as well as also deployment in a scalable way. Imagine if you could skip all these steps and develop applications for the web at record speed. Let me introduce you Stellar Data Store, our new service with seamless integration into TMS Web Core. So I'm ready to take on this challenge to see how fast we can create a fully working web application with TMS Web Core in the front end and the back end service by Stellar Data Store. We'll do this from Delphi 12. So here I can create a new Web Core web client application, and I will enable this convenient little stopwatch tool to let us actually time how long this challenge will take us. So fasten your seatbelts. 3, 2, 1, we get started. And we get started by moving first to the Stellar Data Store website, where you can move to your web application for Stellar Data Store, and from there you can create a new access token to get access from your web client application to the data store. And I will call this application the challenge application, and I give it 30 days access with full access admin privilege. And this access token is created and now copied to the clipboard. So I will quickly paste it here in Notepad so that I can reuse it later. And that's it. We'll not need to use the Stellar Data Store website anymore from now. We can do everything directly outside of the Delphi IDE. I drop the Stellar Data Store client dataset on the form. And we'll need a data source to connect DB-aware controls to this data set. And we will use a navigator as well as a DB grid for editing the data. And the kind of application that we are going to create is a Delphi Books application. So an application that will actually allow us to manage our Delphi books. We'll use it to store the author of the book, the title of the book, the publisher, the publishing date, and we will also add a blob field to allow us to store the cover of the book. So some more controls that I will need in my application is an image control to show us the cover of the book. I'll set the width style to auto, and the height style is fixed. That means that my cover will always appear with the right aspect ratio, but the height will be fixed. And I will use this file upload component. That upload component will enable us to drop the cover on our web application and have it stored in the Stellar Data Store backend. Let's hook up the controls, so the data set to the data store, and also the data source to our DB aware controls, the grid and the navigator. And we'll also need editing. We'll do the editing from the grid, so we enable editing in the DB grid. And now directly from the IDE I can actually connect to the Stellar Data Store, use my access key that I obtained a few moments ago. I'll paste it here and I can connect to my data store. And I will add now a new table. I'll call this table challenge. And this is added now. And what we will need in our database is an author field. It will be a string field. 50 should be sufficient. A book title field, also 50 characters. A publisher field, also 50 characters. The publishing date, that will be a date time field that we add. And we will also add a cover, a blob field that will store the cover of our book. And that's it. That's sufficient. That's created. And you can see that these fields are now automatically added in my data set. What I will need to do, of course, is when I start my application, that is set the access token to my data set, and of course also make it active. So I set this to true, and here we will paste the access token that we obtained a few moments ago, like this. What I will also add here in code is dealing with either showing the cover of the book when I have clicked a row in the grid, and also allow us to upload the cover via the upload control. We'll do that first. So what I handle is the undropped files event, and that is triggered when I have dropped a file on this control, and there will be at least one file. When that file is dropped, I can request to retrieve this information of the file dropped as an array buffer. So that is a buffer of bytes. That is an asynchronous process. And when that's ready, the event on get file as array buffer is triggered. From here, I can first of all actually preload the image control with the data of the file that was dropped this way. And now my web Stellar data store client dataset component has a method write blob. The field is the cover field, and we can immediately write the array buffer, the binary data that was retrieved this way, to the blob field in our data set. And the next step that I will need to do is when my record changes in the data set, update the image control with the cover that is available for the selected record. So from here, the first thing that I will do is actually retrieve the value of my blob field, also in an array buffer, a buffer of binary data. And I will do that with the opposite method, the read blob as array buffer from my cover field. Note that this read blob as array buffer is an asynchronous function. It needs to do an HTTP request to get that binary data. So that means that I need to mark this method as an async method, so that I can use the await construct with this method. And we'll wait for something of the type TGS array buffer, and we can do it this way. We'll actually only do this when our data set is not in editing or in insert mode, as that does not make much sense to retrieve the blob when it's still being edited or being inserted. So we check the state of our data set, and we do not do anything when it's in insert or in edit mode. So if that's not the case, we will asynchronously retrieve the blob field. And when we have retrieved the array buffer, we do a check that it actually contains data. And when it contains data, what I can do is use the same load from array buffer with this array buffer retrieved in our web image control. Let's double check if we have enabled editing in the grid. It is enabled, so everything should be fine, should be up and running. We're 8 minutes underway, and let's test if our web application works. So let's move to the browser. We see that the navigator is already connected, and now I can actually insert information. We'll add, first of all, the book from Marco Cantu. It's his newest book, Expert Delphi, and that was published by PACT, and it was actually published this year in February 24. And we insert that record. We will also insert the book from our colleague Holger Flick, and his book is Modern Delphi Application Development with Independent Publisher, like this, and the date field that was somewhere in December 2023, and okay, 20, that's better, okay, and let's edit it again, 15/12/2023, and now we have the date. And what I can do now is move to my covers that I have here and drop the book from Holger on this file upload component. And then we move to the book of Marco Cantu, and I also drop it here on the file upload component. And as you can see, everything is nicely stored now in Stellar Data Store. And when I click another record, it shows the proper book cover. And with that, I've shown that in less than 10 minutes, you can create a fully working web application to, in this case, manage your Delphi books. If you have an interest in exploring Stellar Data Store in connection with TMS Web Core, you can apply now to the beta. We are first having a period of a closed beta, followed by a public beta. And for signing up to the closed beta, go to stellards.io, and here you can click to sign up for our closed beta. Give us feedback during this beta phase. We look forward to all your comments, and we especially look forward to hear how productive you are with TMS Web Core in combination with Stellar Data Store.